Hello guys, welcome to the channel. I hope you all are fine and doing great. Today we are going to discuss this fine length of loop problem of GFG. So guys, let's move on to the problem. So here we are given a linked list with n nodes. We are given a linked list with n nodes and we have to find out whether there is a loop or not. Like here 2, 3, 4, 5 make a loop. And here, like here, if this is the case, and c is equal to 4 means task node connected to fourth node, like first, second, third, fourth. So task node connected to this 33. Okay, and now this means our this linked list is in a loop, so we have to find out the size. Size is 33, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So size is equal to 7. You can see this is the size of our linked list, that is 7. And if there is, suppose if c is equal to 0, okay, c is equal to 0 means it does not have any loop, okay, or not. It can contain loop or not, means it does not contain any loop. So what we have to return, we just return 0 because it does not contain any loop. So like here it is 0 and 1, so here 0 is connected to 1, s is equal to 1, so means first number is connected or first node is connected. So answer is equal to 2, means complete linked list is connected. So we have to find out how we will find out. So see here, time complexity is on, means you cannot traverse your linked list in on square time, and space complexity is on, so you cannot store the all the nodes in your map and then check whether we have visited this particular node before or not. So you have to do it in on. So guys, how we will do it? So first of all, I just want to tell you, if you don't know the like here, if this is our given linked list. Suppose if this is our given list, this is not first, this is second, this is third, this is fourth, and this is fifth. Here n is equal to 5 and c is equal to 2. Why 2? Because our second node is connected to our last node. Okay. So how we will do it? So guys, you can see we will take slow and fast pointer initially, both of these point to the starting node. Okay. In starting, you can see I am taken 2 pointer, temp I also taking, but I don't have any use of it now. So temp, and I initialize all of them with head. Okay, so these both point to starting. Then what I am doing, slow will move just one way ahead, and while fast will move two way ahead, like next to next. Fast will move like this, so fast come here, whether these are equal, not. So again now S will move one part, and F will also move 2 part. F come here, they are equal, not. S will move 1 part, S will come here, F come here. So now you can see F has completed one cycle of our this loop. F has completed one cycle in this case. It can be complete as many cycle can be possible. Suppose if we have a 1 lakh node here and just a cycle of just 2 node, then F will again and again complete the cycle in each iteration. You can see, okay, now our F is here. I just change the color to make it more clear. So now our F is here, our S is here. So next move, S is, where is our S? No, it is 5. It is 5. So our S will come here. Okay, this is our S. So now our F will come next to next. So F will come here. So you can see all of both of them are at same node, that is this node. So you can name that this node as M. This is your starting node. This is your O, means opening node of the loop. This is the starting node of the loop. Starting node of linked list. You can name it as starting node of loop cycle. I name it as cycle. It is starting node of linked list, starting node of cycle, meeting node of slow and fast pointer. So guys, now you know the speed of our first pointer is equal to speed of 2 into speed of our slow pointer. So distance covered by first pointer is equal to 2 into distance covered by slow pointer. Now distance cover, now suppose this all has length c, this all has length a, this all has length a, okay, and suppose this main meeting point. What is this meeting point? This meeting point, like this, have length b. Suppose now what is our first pointer distance? First pointer will move this a distance, okay, plus first pointer complete some round of cycle. So complete, it will suppose it will complete n round of cycle. So it is n into c. N is the round of cycle, c is the length of our cycle. This is n into c. Plus it will also complete this, after completing it will come to this, after complete each round of cycle it will come to this. Now it will again move some b distance also, okay, to meet the slow pointer. Now it is 2 into what is our distance of our slow pointer, a, plus it will just move b, plus it will just move b, okay, it will just move b. So now we can say 1 a and b we go here and minus, so our 2 will now neutral. So we can write it as n minus 1 into c plus c minus b, this b come here, is equal to a, is equal to a. So we can write it as like this. I haven't changed the color because this is the important step now. So now as you can see, after completing the c distance, after completing it will start from here and come again here, it start from here, come again here. So distance covered by our first is 0, okay, distance is equal to n minus 1 into c, but displacement is 0 because after completing a cycle it again come to this move. So we can say net displacement is equal to 0 plus c minus b, plus c minus b is equal to a, plus c minus b is equal to a. So now we can see our, now we can see our a is equal to c minus b, a is equal to c minus b. This is the most important step. Now what is our a, what is our a, our a is this, our c minus b, what is our c minus b, our c minus b is this, what our c minus b, this is complete c, this is b, this is b. So c minus b is this, between m to sc, m to sc. So guys, and we know our temp is here, our temp is still here, temp node. What is temp node? This temp node, our still a starting point, our meeting node is this, so our s is there. So as if I move my temp a times it, and I move my s c minus b times it, then they both will meet at this position, and this is a starting node of my loop, okay, this is the starting node of my loop. So after meeting at a particular point of slow and fast pointer, what I will do, I will move my t and I will move my s, and if they both come to a point, then it means because a is equal to c minus b, means they both cover equal distance and come to a position that is the starting node of our cycle. And now we just need to find out the length of this particular cycle. Now we can just traverse, like here we start a loop c1, then 2, then 3, then 4, and if we come again here, then we just return, so our c is equal to 4 and we return the answer as 4. So now if you want to understand this whole concept more clearly, I will add a video link in description of 8 code. You can see from there. That is also my video. I explain very clearly how to find the starting node of the loop, as well as I explain it here also, but from there you can also see the hint, okay, for getting more understanding. So now we run a loop while our first next and first next to next. Why this? Because our loop can contain cycle or node. It is not compulsory that it contain a cycle or node, okay. So we make slow to slow next, while fast will move two distance, fast next to next. And if our slow is equal to fast, if our slow is equal to fast, means we are come at this particular position. Now I just highlighted some more highlight. Okay, now we are at here, means our S is at here, means they both are meet. Then what we are doing? If our slow is equal to fast, then while my temp is not is equal to slow, means while my this temp is not is equal to slow, I will move my fast, okay. So they will, this loop will end, this loop will end when they both are starting node of my cycle. Now I am making a C. C is a count of the total number of nodes in my cycle is equal to 1. I take other temp1 variable of node type and put out the address of temp next. Means our temp is this, our temp is this. So now our C is equal to 1. C is equal to 1 and my T1. And my T1 is this. This is my T1. Okay. Now it will run for this, so it will update to 2. Now it will come to this. It will come to T2. T1. Now count is equal to 3. It will again come to this. T1. Now T1 point to this. Now it is 4. Now T1 come to this. T1 come to this. But now you can see our T1 and temp. Our T1 and temp are equal, so we just cut out and return this C. So means 4 is our final answer. You can see while temp1 is not equal to temp, we putting temp1 to temp1x and increment our C, and at last we just return C. Means we found a loop. Slow is equal to fast means we found a cycle. We found a cycle and we return the number of nodes in my cycle. Else while if this condition never work and our fast next is equal to null or our fast next to next is equal to null. Means our while loop will stop. While loop will stop means there is not any cycle, because if there is cycle, then we are never be come out of the loop. So means there is no cycle, then we just return 0. So now I am running this. So you can see answer is correct 7 that we required as well. So you can see all the 1100 test cases pass out. Time taken is on 0.23 and given time is 1.4. So I hope you all understand the, you all like the approach. If you still want to know how to find this starting node more clearly, then you can see the video that I link in my description box. Linked list cycle 2 is the name of the problem on lead code. Okay, I am adding the link in description. You can watch that video also for finding the starting node of the cycle of linked list. I hope you will understand this, and if you still have any doubt, then just comment out. I will try my best to explain you. Meanwhile, you can subscribe the channel and like the video and press the bell button also, and please comment if you subscribe if you understand, then please comment as well. Thank you for watching this, guys. Stay tuned.